Atomicity is the number of atoms present in a molecule of an element is called atomicity. In Cl2, atomicity of Cl is 2, in H2 it is 2, in P4 it is 4. So what now question is, what is atomicity? Atomicity is the number of atoms present in a molecule of an element. For example, Cl2. Cl2, in case of Cl2, two atoms of Cl is present. So atomicity of Cl is 2. In P4, the four atoms of phosphorus is present. So the atomicity of phosphorus is 4. Next one is valency. Do you know valency? What is valency? Valency of an element denotes its combining capacity. Different elements have different valency. For example, the valency of hydrogen is 1, valency of magnesium is 2, valency of aluminium is 3, valency of carbon is 4, the valency of nitrogen is 3. So different elements have different valency. It is the combining capacity of an element. Now I shall tell you about chemical equation. It is a chemical reaction in which reactants and products are represented by symbols and formulae. So chemical equation, it is a chemical reaction in which reactants and products are represented by symbols and formulae. For example, H2 plus O2 forms H2 2H2. This is balanced equation. Now what is balanced equation? If the number of atoms of every element in reactants and products are same, then it is called balanced equation. Here H2 and O2 are called reactants and H2O is called product. So reactants are 2 here, H2 and O2, and product is H2O. Now question is, how can you form a formula? For the formation of a formula, write down first the elements present in that compound. For example, water. In case of water, hydrogen and oxygen, these two elements take part to form water. You know that the valency of oxygen is 2 and the valency of hydrogen is 1. Now interchange the valency. 2 valency comes near hydrogen and 1 valency goes to oxygen. So they form H2 and O1 or H2O. So different compounds and different elements, the symbol of different elements and the formula of different compounds are given in your book. You have to learn all the formula, all the of various compounds and all the symbols of different elements, and we have also solved after reading this chapter. Whatever I taught you, you have to revise, learn the definition, and you have to also revise your book, read your book properly, and solve the multiple choice questions and other different questions given in your book. Thank you. This is all about your structure of matter.